slices of young Woodridge, Rusty's Pizza, and KERN News Talk 1410.
Hello, Kern County. I'm Vance Palm. Good evening, Bright House football fans. That's my partner in time, Brian Adams. You know, Brian, tonight we're in Week 8, Game 8, a huge game. As I'm driving over here tonight, you see the lights on. You drive up. The place is packed already. It's the number one offense of North High School against the number one defense of Centennial High School. One versus one, identical records, both battling for a premier spot in this league. Let's talk about the mental preparation of both teams tonight. First of all, North High School.
Well, North High just has to come out and execute. They have to practice hard, get a good week of practice, which I believe they've had. They're going to come out and play their best game against Centennial.
If you're Centennial, 31-0 since the inception of the league that they are now in. 31, that's a huge number, Brian. 31-0, they haven't lost. Everybody's knocking on your door, looking over your back. Talk about their mental preparation against a team like North that just keeps racking up yards.
Well, their mental preparation is fight, you know, and that's what they've done. They've been able to fight in games and keep into the fourth quarter and beat you because they haven't always had the best stuff, but they found a way to win.
On both sides of the ball tonight, we will start with the head coach of North High School, Coach Snow. We'll see what he has to hear, say, and we'll hear what he has to say about some things about North High School on both sides of the ball. Coach Snow.
Tonight's game with Centennial should be real physical, real heated battle. Every year it comes down to fourth quarter where the game's won, and I think the team that controls the line of scrimmage and plays the best defensively has got the chance of winning, and the team that doesn't turn the ball over probably going to control the clock and win the game, but it should be a physical, good high school football game.
Brian, this North High School squad, 2 weeks ago we watched them play against South. Everything about them is uniformity, team, they just rack up yards. Your general sense of North High School?
Well, I just believe North plays a well-rounded game, but I think the one thing that they do lack is a defensive effort for a whole game. I think tonight, if they bring that defensive effort with their offense, they could end that Centennial streak.
For the Centennial Golden Hawks, Coach Nixon, he's been at the helm here for a while, and as we said, 31-0 in league play. He obviously has some thoughts on what he has to achieve tonight on both sides of the ball. Let's hear from head coach of the Golden Hawks, Coach Nixon. Coach.
This guy's a good football team. They have one of the most explosive offenses in the Valley. And, you know, we have to be very disciplined tonight defensively. And I think maybe our best defense will be to control the football offensively and, you know, high percentage passes and things like that. So try to keep their offense off the field.
Brian, the Golden Hawks, we've covered a lot of their games in the last 2 years now, and it's our third game this season. They played tough against Edison. They shut out BHS, not an easy thing to do, and now a big game tonight. Your overall picture of the Golden Hawks?
Well, the Golden Hawks have ball control offense, as Coach Nixon alluded to, but also they have a stifling defense and well-rounded special teams, and that's why they have 31 wins in this league.
You and I talked about it this week. We talked about it last week. We talk about it every day. The news covers it. It's always in the newspapers. We're talking about statistics. And when it boils down to it, this is the number one offense against the number two defense. I mean, against the number one defense, one versus one. But you can just toss that out, can't you?
Yeah, you can, because you never know from week in, week out what they're going to do and who they played against. But in this game, this is for all the marbles. I believe the team that wins this is going to have the top dog towards winning this championship.
That's Brian Adams. I'm Vance Palm. Back with a kickoff. Week 8, Game 8 of Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. Can't wait to get to B's 3 here when we get the kickoff. What a big ball game. Number one offense against the number one defense. Back in a moment with the kickoff.
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woodridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woodridge, integrity you can trust.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
You miss out.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
Oh,
look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah! 101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work. Listen at home. Listen in the car. The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
July 14th, 2004, a.k.a. Black Wednesday, a dark day when there are no sports scheduled.
You hanging in there?
I'm managing.
Luckily, digital cable brings you in-demand sports packages, so days like these are rare. And you can live sports with access to more of the teams, players, and matchups you can't see anywhere else. Plus a unique in-car race experience. Whatever sport you live, add it to your digital cable lineup and get access to the teams, players, and matchups you can't see anywhere else.
Welcome back, Kern County. Look at this. Brian Putman on the return. If you just made it to your couch or wherever you're watching this ball game from, welcome to Week 8, Game 8 of Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. I'm Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams, exclusively for Bright House Network. What a big ball game. Centennial on offense at home, 31-0 in league play since they've become a league member. North High School, also 2-0 in league this season. Number one defense versus number one offense, not in this series, but next series. Brian Adams, it's first and 10. Here comes the Golden Hawks. Morrell across the middle, completely overthrows what really, truly was an open Matt Smith. Brian, let's do your B's threes here right away for the Centennial Golden Hawks and see what you have to say about these talented guys.
Okay, man. Talking about Centennial High School, first of all, man, they have to control the line of scrimmage offensively and defensively. Second, they have to continue to make big plays defensively. We see them in the three games that they've played so far on Bright House. And third, that's going to leave the offense scoring more than 24 points. I think they're going to have to score some points tonight to beat North.
Second and 10, Morrell. Hands the ball off to Curtis Cornelson. Cornelson met hard and heavy at the line of scrimmage and nothing doing there. That'll bring up third and long.
And man, these are the situations that you want to get Centennial High into, man. You want to get them in third and long where they're forced to pass the ball. And so far in the first two plays, a missed opportunity on a big pass play by Centennial, then a good forming pressure defense right there against the run by the North High Stars, and forced to third and 10.
Third and 10, first series of the ball game, just starting. Morrell behind center for the Golden Hawks. He's getting rushed. It's a fumble, and it looks like it may be recovered by North High School unless Morrell got it.
Come on, let's go! Lock the bus up!
Regardless of that, Centennial is going to have to come on and punt. Here's our first Rusty's replay, Brian, and it's a big one.
Yeah, and this is the blitz strip, the middle right there, Vance. And he's untouched and knocked the ball loose.
That's Jerry White.
And Jerry White, who had a big game offensively in the game we saw against South, comes through with a big play defensively. And they're not starting off, Vance, like one of the lower echelon defenses in the area.
Well, Brian, can't think of a better time to, during this stoppage of play, to talk about a North High School team that is looking for that big word, respect. Last night, one of the major affiliates did a sports cover story on North High School looking for respect. 2 weeks ago, we picked player of the game from the losing team from South High School. Not out of disrespect for North, that's for sure, but this is a team that, as you say, tonight can earn it.
Yeah, and they're going to have to earn it by getting a W. If you get the W, people will respect the win.
Centennial gets the punt off. It's going to take probably a squirrely little bounce here, and it does. Ends up at about the 33-yard line of North High School. That's where they'll take over. And this team, as you say, North High School, wants some respect. Last week they took a thumping from Lemoore that they didn't expect. And now they're up against one of the most powerful teams in the county. Big opportunity to earn that respect.
Well, they have a good chance of getting from the night because Cody Stone is the quarterback for the North High team. And I like the way he runs his ball club. When things are not going down, he gets up on the sideline, gets the guys going. Look for a big game for Cody.
First and 10, first pass right out of the shoot for the North High School Stars. And it's quarterback Cody Stone on a 13-yard bullet out there to number 82. Anthony Gonzalez. So we talk about the ground game from North all the time, and it was going to be expected. We'll see it tonight, but we know about Cody Stone, don't we?
Oh, yeah, we do. And right there, you just see a strong arm out right there. Good play by the receiver to turn around and catch it. Anthony Gonzalez.
First and 10, second play of the game, Kyle Hilton.
And Jerry White.
Sorry, that's Jerry White, number 35. Bangs up the middle, so maybe second and inches. So in two plays, North High School has gone 24 yards. Wow. Pitch out to the left. Weiss and Hoppe gets the first down. First down, North High School Stars, and they're already at the Centennial Goldenhawks 36-yard line. Brian, are you shocked at all?
No, I'm not. The one thing that we know about North High, as I come back to, we're going to do a B3 first. And here it is with North B three. The defense must hold up. Man, you already see them on the first series jump up. Second, turnovers will be costly. They cannot afford to turn the ball over. They have to get up early, and right now they're on their way to doing that.
The big fellow right to the middle just keeps banging, and hey, look at this. This is Jerry White again. Another first down. So, what is it, four plays, three first downs, Brian?
Yeah, and you know, and Hokie on that last run did a great job. He was screening out Vance, and he just cut up and put the first down. And this is what North has the ability to do. They have the ability to hit you with three or four different runners and then attack you with Cody Stone on ground or in the air. They have a wide open offense, and I think that's why they're the number one offense in the area.
First and 10, North High School Stars just under the 9-minute mark here in the first quarter. Stone drops back. He's got all kinds of pressure on him from his Golden Hawk defense. He fires one out. It is caught at the 12-yard line. What a great catch out there by Ryan Steele. And we've seen this connection before. We're going to see it again tonight. But the Golden Hawk defense wasn't for lack of pressure, but Cody Stone kept his wits about him. And
well, right here,
John,
his mobility does a good job avoiding the sack right there. Squares his shoulders up, and he throws a strike on the sideline. Only where his receiver can get it still does a good job of securing the catch. A lot of receivers will worry about the sideline, not secure the catch. Great job by Ryan Steele.
Carries by number 10, Kyle Hilton. Hilton, he slashes upwards of about 4 to 5 yards. And every play is a big chunk of yards, except for that one first down that was picked up, albeit a first down. It was a 3-yard run. Now, all of a sudden, these guys are just moving.
There they are. And again, Vance, they have Hopi in the backfield, Hilton in the backfield, White in the backfield, Stone throwing the ball to Steele, to Gonzalez, and his ability to run. So they can do it, Vance.
Second and 7. Up the middle, Hilton on the carry. He gets up to about the 3-yard line. Brian, one of the things that we know about Centennial is they've got a very, very tough defense. That's it. They're number one in 11-man football here. But right now, it's getting served to them.
You know, this rusty replay, this is just straight ahead. Our offensive line is dominating your defensive line, and we're going to run the ball down your throat. And they can still pick up a first down without scoring a touchdown, Vance.
Third and 1. They're about 3.5 yards out. So as you say, they can still get a first down and pound away a little more. And Cody Stone, the quarterback, seems to be inclining that it's already a first down.
You know, Vance, and this is something we're not used to seeing happen from Centennial. We saw Edison do it maybe one series where he just ran the ball down the throat. But for the most part, you do not see teams run the ball like this on Centennial.
Every part of this first few minutes, these Centennial fans have been looking like the Cub fans when that fan started things off in a tumultuous 24 hours for the Cubs. But now, here comes this Golden Hawk fan. They're pounding their feet, Brian. It's 4th and 1. North High School, big decision here. Obviously, after marching out the field, they're going for Stone behind center. Hands the ball up the middle. Look at this. Not only is it a first down, it's a touchdown, North High School. Well, Brian, this North High School crowd came about 6 or 7 miles down the road, but boy, it sounds like they drove from 100 miles away.
Well, I tell you, Vance, that's a very impressive drive. They were 2 for 2 on pass play. They ran the ball effectively, and they just had everything going that first drive. And if they can get it going like that, Vance, it could be a long night for the Golden Hawks.
Extra point out there by Parker Reynolds is about a 50-yard extra point. So 7-0 North, and they want respect. They've got it early. See if they can hang on and make this a big-time game we all expect.
And what you see right here is a split power football right there. This is a smash-up straight up the middle, and this is a touchdown for North. But I'll tell you one thing, in terms of respect, one guy that I know and his staff does give the North High group some respect, and that's Coach Nixon. They don't overlook their opponents. and they've been in a situation before, Vance. So I look for North Centennial to crank it up back on offense. But if this defense from North can put that kind of pressure they did on the first series the whole game, it could be a very difficult challenge for the Golden Hawks to go 32-0 in the league.
That's Brian Adams. I'm Vance Palm. Welcome to all of you Bright House Network football fans. If you're at a friend's house and you don't have Bright House Network after this football game, you'll be ordering it for this reason and many others. Here we go. Kickoff. Centennial will field it. It's going to be caught at the 10-yard line by David Hubbard. Hubbard right up the gut. Looks for some blocking. Has a nice little nifty move there and gets up. He's still running.
I tell you, Vance, that's a great job right there, getting up into the wedge and just driving his legs and pulling the pile about 10 yards. But I tell you, in our three games we've done so far with Centennial, Vance, I'm really impressed with the special teams play.
Both times they've had pretty decent field position, and right here is a really good position. Look at this run right here by Robin Johnson.
And look how close he is to the wedge. That's the one thing we haven't seen a lot of teams do. When that wedge is that close, it allows the runner to get some open spaces and make some moves and get some good runs. And right there, Hubbard does a good job of just taking the pile there, about 4 or 5 stars.
Big run. Centennial starts on their own 41-yard line. They need to get things going here. Morrell to Sparks. Sparks met early and hard and thrown back for a loss of at least 5 to 6 yards, and that'll be second at about 15. So the North High School's been just basically perfect so far.
Advance, I'm going to apologize on that return. That was Johnson, not Hubbard, running the ball back. But they said the momentum stopped for Sparks, and that they gave him a break and only moved it back a yard. So,
oh goodness,
they avoided a real disastrous play.
So that makes it second and 11. Surprises me. I thought he was thrown for a bit more of a loss than that. 6:17 left, as the clock says right in front of you in this first quarter. Morrell with a long count, option, decides to keep. Got a ton of room. Looks for an upfield block. Gets a pretty decent block out there by J.P. Masuda, and that's a nice first down for the Golden Hawks.
Yeah, and that's a good adjustment right there by Coach Nixon. Obviously, they found the key in on their run, so they just use a little dive, fake dive, and then go and run the option and get Morrell on the outside. And he does a good job of not pitching on this one. Right there, you're faking the dive. He's coming out. There's nobody out there, as you can see on the rest of the replay. Does a good job picking up the first down and going out on the sideline.
Remember, football fans, last year, Jeff Crosby ran this offense to a T and had two juniors competing for this job this year and a senior, and it was Morrell that ended up with a spot, and he knows how to run this offense. Just under 6 minutes left in this first quarter. Caprioli in motion. Sparks with the handoff. Nothing doing up the middle. The North High School crowd celebrating 50 years in their history in Kern County this season, and it's been a special season for them, and they're having a good year. And you know, we covered them 2 weeks ago, and they just played great, great football, Brian.
Yeah, they did. You know, that's a game where they knew they had a team where they had a little more advantage on, and they kept them down the whole game. That's what they're supposed to do. And right there, Jerry White has recently had a big game offensively and defensively, and again tonight, he's doing the same thing.
Second and 12 for the Jayhawks. 5.5 left in the first quarter. Again, Caprioli heading west. Cuts across the middle. Throws out to number 11, Braden Bowles. Braden Bowles has seen significant action so far from Morrell in the air. He's having a pretty decent season himself. A nice throw.
Yeah, and right there, Scott Allison's on the defense, and he's going to just throw him down there. You see right here, just a quick hit to Bowles. Just securing the catch, and trying to take as many yards as he can. And it's like Ryan Steele's the one that slams him down.
Ryan Steele with a big-time tackle. 4:44, third and four in the first quarter. Morrell had Chris Chica behind him, and Chica, number 40, can really pound it through the line, so you never really know what play they had designed. We'll never know. False start on the offense, and that changes things just a bit here, Brian.
Well, yeah, by moving back 5 yards, it allows you to be in third and nine, but it also allows that defense to be more in attacking mode, and you see right there the guard's moving, and he knows he made a mistake, and they start back 5 yards, but you know, man, one thing you've got to be wary of and against the Hill team is that tight end leaking out behind your secondary and picking up a big catch.
Third and nine for the Golden Hawks. Big test here early. Fake by Morrell. Throws across the middle to Caprioli. Caprioli with a nice catch, but he's not going to get the first down. that second tier defense out there, the Stars really held their own.
They did, and Cap really did a good job almost through the first down. He has a spot that would probably be a yard short. But right there's a quick wide receiver call, like a smash to a wide receiver, and Cap really did a good job catching the ball and goes upfield and is just short of the first down. And looks like Centennial's going to go for it right here.
Fourth and one. North High School went for it a few moments ago, but they're on the goal line. Get ready to pound it in right here. Centennial would have to give up the ball right around the 33-yard line of North if they don't get it. Fourth and one. Big play early. Morrell up the middle. Keeps it. First down. Nice, nice play. Well executed. Brian, it's one of those plays where it just never had a doubt. Never looked like there was a doubt.
No, you know, it looks like they caught the North defense not ready either. Like they were kind of waiting for them to get set. And they're already ready and hiked the ball. And easy first down for Morrell right there.
Well, we know that hustle up North offense. But Centennial maybe watching tapes and studying them and saying, man, I like that. You know, I like how they get up to the line early and just get things done. First and 10, Centennial on the North High 30-yard line. They're trying to get into the neighborhood here. And that handoff up the middle to Curtis Cornelson gets about 2 or 3 yards, and this is how we know Centennial. Now that they're back in this slugging fest, they're going to keep slugging.
Well, that's what they're going to do. You know, as long as they don't let North High get too far ahead where they have to be in a passing situation, I think Centennial's going to be okay. If they can hang within 7, 10 points, they know they can continue to the game plan. When they get down by 14, 21, they're going to have problems.
Well, Brian, the ball hasn't not been in the air at all or very little, just a few plays. So we're already into the 3-minute mark here in the first quarter. Second and 8, Golden Hawk. Morrell to Sparks. Sparks tries to get outside. He's got the speed, but that one delayed step was enough for Scott Allison to catch him and throw him down. We've seen a lot from Sparks this year, but he's maybe early on starting to figure out, wow, I better get some holes here. These guys are fast.
Well, I think, too, people start knowing Sparks, you can do some stuff, and people start setting the D's. You've seen the rest of the replay. He just kind of flips right there and loses momentum. You don't really hesitate, but good inside-out play by the linebacker there. Scott Allison, as he makes it for a tackle for a loss and puts him in a third and long where a little smash screen might have to go a little bit further downfield this time.
Third and 11 from the shotgun. Morrell barks out his orders. He's got Chica back there blocking. He looks across the middle. It's DiCaprioli. First down or not, that's awesome.
Yeah, it is. And it is going to be a first down. And good pass and good catch right there.
Boy, as a fan, I'd like to see this Rusty's replay.
And right here, he's doing a good job. Morrell knows he has him. He's going to release the ball. I like how the ball is so nice and hard and behind on the outside for the receiver's downfield shoulder. So he has a chance to secure the catch, and the defensive back cannot make a play. Good pitch and catch.
Yeah, great catch, and just a BB out there by Morrell. Threw it on a line and in traffic. First and 10 from the 14-yard line. Here comes Centennial. They're most definitely in the neighborhood. I formation, Sparks deep. Morrell, hands off, fakes it. Nice play. And look at this, Matt Smith in the action. So they're spreading the ball out on the ground on the air. Here's your Rusty's replay. Great play action.
Well, this is what I'm talking about, Vance. This is a little play they have, a little play action. And Matt Smith, the tight end, drags across the other side of the field. That's why he scored a big touchdown against BHS doing that same kind of action. And I haven't seen a game yet against Centennial when they haven't put that pass play in and completed it.
Chica and Sparks in the I formation. They've got 4 tries from the 3-yard line to get it in. Chica up the middle.
Hand off to Chica.
Stopped and taken down at about the 1.5-yard line. We're at 1 minute left in this first half. It's just flown by, Brian. We knew that would happen if they don't put it up.
Well, Vance, they're putting up a few times, but the difference is their completion. You know, when you're completing the ball and you're catching the ball in play, it's just like a running play with the clock.
53, 52, 51. Coming up towards the end of the first quarter. And again, Chica just gets stopped there on a Rusty's replay. Here we go, 2nd and 2. Morrell on a keeper, and it looks like he got in to me. He did. Touchdown, Golden Hawk.
And Morrell got him again. It's the same play, Vance. He pulled on the first down. So those North High defensive line, they're going to have to get set and get ready because when he's getting that close to the first down of the goal line, the Golden Hawks aren't playing around with him. They're getting set. Morrell's calling his cadence and getting the ball, and he's getting in easy. But not even close to not getting the touchdown on the first down.
Extra point. Attempt being kicked by Josh Bright. Boy, can Josh kick. Both of these kickers tonight and both teams really have a nice leg on them. And we know Bright can boot it. It's up and it's good. 7-7.
Going after by Josh Bright is good there.
We've got some laundry on the field. And it's a legal procedure against the offensive side, so the Golden Hawks have to put it up again. That's no hill to a climber like Bright.
No, I mean, he kicked it well over the little grandstand there they have in the back, so I don't think it's going to be much more of a kick for him. But we've seen last week a missed extra point can come up really big in a close game.
David Carrillo from the Bakersfield, California, the beat writer for high school football. He's become a very famous guy here early in his career in Bakersfield and Kern County. He'll be our third quarter guest. You Bright House Network football fans get a chance to meet one of the scribes here in town that just does a great job. Been here just such a short time, and Brian, you and I know he's picked up real quick, and he's a sharp, sharp guy. I look forward to having him on our third quarter portion of the program. Here's our second PAT. This one hopefully is clean, and it'll make it 7-7. Let's see. Bright with a kick. Perfect snap, perfect hold. It's up and it's good. I think we're cleaning it 7-7. So, Brian, let me ask you a question here. 7-7-0-0, or it could be 21-21, 55-55. They're back to square even here again. North's got to feel good, though. They're getting the ball here. They scored quickly last series.
Well, I think, you know, for North, you got to feel good because you were playing with a half field. And the percentage to tell you, when teams offensively have that sort of field, they usually result in some kind of points, a field goal or a touchdown. The thing for North is, this is really their first chance when they're going to drive the field unless they get a really big return. So they only had about 65 yards to go the last time. So we'll see what they can do, if they can keep up that consistent pounding of the ball, peppering in some nice passes to move the ball down the field and put themselves in strong position. I think they're going to have to put points up on the board and force Centennial to get to a shootout tonight.
This North High School offense, it's heralded offense, averaging over 400 yards a game, 402.6. Total yards, 2,818, 1,780 on the ground, 1,035 in the air, 314 points. Is that the scoring?
Yeah.
So they know how to get into the end zone. They know how to move down this field. Centennial defense keeping teams to 177 yards. Here's our kickoff, and it's a long boot in the corner. No one's returning this baby, so it'll be first and 10 on the 20-yard line. And, you know, it's normal, Brian, when you start reading teams that are number one or something, very rarely do you see individuals way up at the top of the list on either one of these teams. And
you know, and Centennial, we're talking about defense, only getting up 54 points a game, so they've had a few shutouts. And I think the most points they've given up all year are 24 against Edison, so.
54 points in a season, you mean?
Yeah, and I think 24 of those from Edison, so. They play very good defense, and they don't get a lot of points, so we'll have to see, like I said, if North can get them into a shootout.
Well, Stone was going to throw it, so that would have been the second straight opening pass on a series, but laundry on the field. We've got a flag, and it's against North High School.
Outside penalty against North High. 5-yard penalty.
Brian, 41 seconds left in this first quarter.
15.
If you're a football fan, if you're an action fan, it's already a real nice football game to watch.
Yeah, because you're getting some really nice, solid runs. We've seen some good defensive plays already. And you're getting some passing, so you're really getting a good mixture of all the facets of a football game.
Some fans are coaches, and they like to see technical matchups. And if you're just a flat-out fan and want to see great plays, it's a good ball game. First and 15, handoff goes out to number 24, Jason Morris. Morris around the side and thrown for a loss, possibly.
Yeah, and that's a tough way to run against Centennial going outside. And Centennial does not have dominant speed like you would see in some teams going east to west. What they do is they play disciplined defense. They use the techniques, they shed their man, and they stay in their place. You see right here on the Rusty's replay, there's just nowhere to go if they string it out. They just make it really tough for you to run the ball outside them. I think you have to kind of just suck it up and power the ball on them.
Final play of the first quarter, 8 seconds left. Stone hands the ball up the middle. Again, Jason Morris pounds it up the middle, and that will be the final play of the first quarter. The score is knotted at 7, and we have a super ball game. North High School Stars visiting Centennial Golden Hawks. I'm Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. We'd like to thank our sponsors, KERN 1410 News Talk, the law offices of Young, Wooldridge, and of course, Rusty Pizza. Back in a moment in the second quarter.
this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
You miss out.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
Oh,
look at that. He's doing a frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work. Listen at home. Listen in the car. The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Hey, we're back, Kern County. Bright House Network's high school football game of the week, week 8. And last week was a doozy, week 7. VHS marching into Liberty.
Watch out! Watch out!
And upsetting the Patriots. And we'll talk about the games going on tonight, but right now it's North High School. Cody Stone drops back. He's got a man open. He's launched it up there, but just a little inside him and behind him, but
Anthony Gonzalez
is out there sprinting pretty hard, and North High School just going at him.
Yeah, and Gonzalez had a step on him, and there was a chance for a big completion, but Stone was off on his first pass play, and that's the first one he's really missed, but I would look for them to come back to that later in the game, man.
North High School will punt it. It's 4th and 12. And looking at some of the other facts and figures.
China, North High.
The Kern County rankings, top 10 compiled by the staff writer David Correa, who we'll meet here in the third quarter, has North ranked 6th, Centennial ranked 2nd. So it's a battle of some really high-ranked teams that have proven themselves so far this season. And we've got Burroughs out of town ranked at 1, Stockdale at 3, West at 4, Liberty at 5. That's good company to be in if you're North High School.
Yeah, it is. You know, and the thing about that is that just gives you kind of a barometer of where you may fall in the area or the section. But again, that's what you want to be. You want to be in the top 5, top 10. That means you're playing some really solid football.
Just underway here in the second quarter. I'm Vance Palm. We've got Brian Adams next to me. We're having a super time. Oh, high snap. The punt is up, and it does get nicked a little bit, but it takes a real straight Centennial bounce, and it's going to be out there by Putnam. Putnam picks it up, and he's brought down. Just a super special teams play out there by Jerry White. Jerry White is, man, oh, man, is he a player.
Yeah, he is. I mean, he's Mr. Everything, looks like, for North High. He runs the ball, plays linebacker, right? He does a good job of coming down. I like how he breaks down, stays under control, shoots the leg like a wrestler, holds on to him. And looks like he's down already, but he's fighting there, and Putman takes another hit. And looks like, I don't know who number that is, we couldn't see it, but that was good special teams coverage, because Putman is dangerous as a return man.
Young Woldridge, athlete of the week here a few weeks back, Brian Putman. 1st and 10, Centennial. Great field position on the 46-yard line of their own territory. Sparks cuts up the middle. Sparks, dangerous, quick, fast, first down. That's a 13, 14, 15-yard run. And Sparks is electrifying. Our second game, when we covered him with VHS, he was not a factor, injured, didn't play, but you have to know he's chomping at the bit, hungry tonight.
Well, I think they did this time. They gave him a lead blocker for a kick out. Sparks going to cut it up. And this is where I think Sparks had the advantage against the North defense in his speed. He has the speed to run by some of the North Star defenders that might not be as fleet of foot.
Sparks up the middle.
Once again.
Doesn't look like much, but 6 yards.
Stopped by Jerry White.
Like I said, I think this is one thing that North High, I think, has to bring tonight. That's their defense. And so far, the defense held in the first series. But this is the second time where they've had to go against good field position against Centennial. And they have to go to force that three down and punt. But I think they have to suck it up right now to me and not allow Centennial to get another touchdown up.
Second and five. North shifting on the front line. I formation. Chicken Sparks. Quarterback option. A keeper. Morrell decides to keep him. Not only does he break a couple tackles, he breaks three or four big ones. It'll be first and 10 from the North High School 7-8 yard line. And Brian, you had just spoken 10 seconds, 15 seconds ago about really the key parts of this game for North High School, and that's their defense stepping up.
Right here, this is going to fake this little option to the dive. You can see Morrell run through a tackle, run through another tackle. And right here, does a good job of securing the ball.
Morrell getting to the
He's going to put as many yards as he can. But what's happening is they don't have good a defensive attack to stop that option. There's nobody coming to get the dive man, the quarterback, and the safety's not filling for the pitch man.
First and goal for the nine. Sparks. Cuts outside, maybe gets two or three. And Brian, watching Morrell run down there, that quarterback for Centennial, it's, if you just blew your eyes a little bit, it looks like Crosby from last year, and that he just fits this offense to a T, doesn't he?
Well, the one thing that Coach Nixon looks for, I believe, in his quarterback, they have to make plays, whether it be with their legs or their arms. Passing-wise, they have to be accurate. He's not worried about it. He doesn't ask them to throw the ball 60 yards downfield or ask them to throw the ball 30 times a game. He's going to ask them to throw the ball about 12, 15 times a game, be accurate, and make some plays with your legs when we need you to.
Second and goal from the eight, split way out left. Caprioli and J.P. Mazuda. The pitch is out left. Could be a reverse. No, just a crackback blocked by number 15, J.P. Mazuda, but it doesn't work. Could be a fumble.
Starts the ball carrier.
That'll be third down. Well, maybe our Rusty's replay will show us what all the brouhaha was over there on a possible turnover. What I do know is that J.P. Masuda on a crackback block thought he was going to open up something. It didn't happen.
Well, this time they did a good job of coming up. They attacked the blockers. He went the crackback back. The secondary came up like it's supposed to, forcing Sparks to go up front. Looks like his ball came out, and he did fall back on it. So that was fortunate to get that bounce right there from Sparks, but the situation where you look for Caprioli.
Morrell rolls right, throws out here to Chica. Chica brought down out there, just an excellent play by Scott Allison, and we've seen Allison make big plays all season long, another big play.
Morrell had Matt Smith wide open in the end zone right there on that little drag play that he runs, but he just wasn't able to get to him as he didn't come to view right here on the replay.
Got pressure.
You see the pressure right there, so he forced the ball to come up short, and he's forced the ball to Chica, and Chica does a good job of catching the ball, and again, 3 points on the board could be big.
You know, it's a big event when the helicopters are flying over trying to find Brian Adams and say, is that the man that does color for Bright House Network's football? And he's spotting us right now.
Yeah, that kind of helicopter's not looking for you for a Bright House.
Oh, my goodness. It's up, and it is as good as ever. Another nice kick by Josh Bright. Makes it 10-7. It's a three-pointer that, as you say, in tough games like this, when these teams are matched up one versus one, 3 points is nice.
Yeah, you know, and 3 points can make a big deal, because if you're able to put another touchdown up, they have to score twice to tie the game. So, you know, we know that the Centennial defense, man, plays tough defense, and gives a lot of points. And if North, like I said, is going to have a chance, they're going to have to put some points on the board and force that shootout. They're going to have to get some good field position. They started last time on the 20 with a touchback, and then they had a 5-yard penalty. They were first and 15 with 85 yards to go, and I think they have to get good field position, because you've seen tonight three scores off three situations where field position was very good for both teams.
Yeah, if these clubs get the ball around the 50-yard line, man, they're going to be in the neighborhood. They're going to be knocking on the door. They're powerful. 10-7. Golden Hawks lead by three. They'll kick off. North High School has five up front, two in the middle, and four deep back there to catch this kickoff. And everything about North High School is like, it's almost like I want to say they're built like an arrow, if you know what I mean. Everything is just pointing forward. It's always just a forward thinking, forward direction type of program. 7:58 is when they'll kick this ball off. It's up, and Bright will not get it out of the end zone. Matter of fact, it's going to be caught at about the 9-yard line out there by Anthony Goodwin. Goodwin breaks one tackle, takes a nice hard hit, and gets up to about the 22-yard line. So
Anthony Goodwin on the run back, stopped by Mitchell.
North High School gets a chance to put up some more yards here. We'll see. special hello out there as we see our Rusty's replay. Go ahead, Brian.
And Vance, the one thing you're going to see different, look how the space between the wedge and the return man right here for North. And that's the reason why these guys from Centennial are able to come in and make the touch and make the tackle and keep them to a short game. They're going to have to get that gap close if they want to get a big return against Centennial.
First and 10 for North High. Ooh. Wow. A big hit up there.
Brought down by Mitchell Korak.
So it brings up second and six. Well, we see Ryan Houston out there, the left corner, number two for the Golden Hawks. Special hello to his grandmother, Grandma Lee. Hi, Grandma Lee. Hope you're watching this game and enjoying it. Your grandson's out there doing a fine job. Cody Stone, nice pass out here to the west side of the field. Caught out there by another Ryan Steele, and I'm sure his family's stoked for him as well. So a nice play. That's a first down, I believe, Brian.
Yeah, and they're going back to that little out.
First down.
And look at the velocity of Stone to throw the ball, and it's on the money. Good catch with the hands right there. I like that by Steele. And that's just, again, we're seeing some really good passing routes and completions tonight.
First and 10 North. Stone rolls right. Has a man deep. Can he launch it up that far? He can't. And it is picked off out there by... Well, I guess Grandma Lee's pretty happy now.
Yes, he is. And right there...
Ryan Houston with a pick.
Houston makes a great job on breaking the ball. But Cody just made the wrong read on that one. He threw to a guy with a few Centennial Golden Hawks. He had a guy on the sideline, as you said, Vance. And right here, Cody's going to pull it up. He's going to try to force the ball into the receiver. And you're going to see it. It's in between almost three Golden Hawks. And Houston is right there ready to make the play and jumps on it. And once again, Golden Hawks have a short field.
Well, Houston didn't play the first few series. Came back on here and made his impact known immediately. We know him as a baseball player. And his brother Chris last year, young Wooldridge, athlete of the game. I think it was at DHS. And athletic family, just under 7 minutes to go in this first half. Golden Hawks, big, big opportunity. They show blitz, North does, and they do. Well, if there's anybody that can battle that blitz, it's number 42, Curtis Cornelson. He takes big hits every game.
Well, I think Cornelson did a great job right there, fans, not to lose any yards.
That brings up second and 10, North High School. A very efficient team, doesn't turn the ball over a lot. Head coach Mike Snow, assistant coaches Roman Aguilar, Johnny Kessler, Danny Sasso, and Dan Walters. Trainers Vern Walk. Statistician team is Jerry Conley, Crystal Reed, Amy Ambler. And the video side of things is Stan Brennan, of course, Brian Schaefer, the principal of North High School. They're on D. Centennial's on O, second and nine. Morrell's in trouble. He gets taunted and brought down out there. A beautiful play by this North High School defense, and just a big tackle out there, I think, and I thought it was number 74, Richard Boland. Oh, it was Chris Hyatt. You're right, Chris Hyatt. So just a great play, Brian.
And it was just a cover sack. You want to get rid of the ball. Nobody was open. The defense, I think, did a good job of covering everybody, and Hyatt does a good job of pursuing Morrell and pulls him down.
Third and 14 for the Jayhawks.
And, man, this is a big down right here for the North High Stars. They can force a punt right here. They can get the ball back.
And
it may not be a great position, but you thwarted a drive from relatively a short field.
Less than 5.5 left in the half. North High School coming hard. Morrell across the middle has his receiver, and he finds him. It's Eric Manise, but Eric still comes up about 7 yards shy. So North High School with a big stop here, a big hold, and as we say, down three with this Rusty's replay. They got to get back there in scoring position.
Yeah, right here, Morrell wants to go deeper, but the pressure comes again and makes him force the ball early to Eric Manez, and Manez gets the catch, secures it. Good tackling close there by Anthony Goodwin. And they have to be careful right now and watch Vance. And this is a perfect situation if you continue to go for a fake punt right here. So, you know, they got to be real careful and be heads up if you're North High. And then the return man has to make sure they field the ball.
Number 48, Daniel Longcrier, screaming onto the field to get there in time. And it's already out of bounds. I heard the whistles when it was only about in the air for 2 seconds. So the line judge runs up and marks it out at about the 28-yard line. 4.5 left in the first half. And Brian, this first half has flown by.
Yeah, it has. You know, there haven't been many mistakes, Vance, we've seen tonight. You know, a lot of running the ball and pass completion. So that clock's going to move. But North High, I think, has to get something going this drive. They have to get something positive. They need to move the ball down, get a field goal or a touchdown.
Stone hands the ball off the middle to Kyle Hilton.
Hilton, the ball carrier.
6'1", 185-pound senior. Carried the ball quite a bit 2 weeks ago when the Stars beat the Rebels in the rivalry of the Sword. North versus South, and North played a great ball game. Here is Rusty's replay, and Centennial line doing what it's known to do.
Yeah, and Clarkson Company just did a great job right there on the Rusty's replay, driving Hilton back and keeping to a short game.
Option, Stone pitches it out. Jason Morris hauls in the pitch and hauls in a first down, and boy, that was a, looked like that ball was hanging up there forever.
Yeah, it did, but he got out there. You see the North High fans, they're giving high fives up there, but I tell you what I like. I like the blocking by Ryan Steele down this receiver. Look at this right here. Ties up this man, Putman. Putman's able to barely make the tackle and saves a really big game. But it's a first down nonetheless, and the chains are moving.
Again, another lesson from Brian for you younger players out there. If you're a receiver and you start to feel everybody running up the backside, that means you better still be blocking. First and 10, hand off to Hilton up the middle. Brian, let's talk about that. We talked about this last week. If you're out there blocking as a receiver and you're one of these young players growing up in Jack Frost League, and you hear footsteps behind you, the play's still going, huh?
Yeah, it is. And you know, you just kind of have a feel for it. You can kind of hear it, and you know, you haven't heard that whistle, you know it's coming. You got to stay out there and get the defensive back away. You don't have to go do a cockroach block and knock him on his back and roll him over. Just tie him up and let the running back make a miss as he goes, picks one way or the other.
Stone drops back, wants to throw deep. Cocks his arm, has a man open. Oh, big play at the end out there by Robin Johnson. And that pass isn't thrown a foot behind him. That receiver's running into the end zone.
Well, if he throws it earlier.
There you
know,
go.
Because you said it was open, Vance, a lot of times. Just right here, just a little late and a little pressure by Clark forced the ball to come up a little short and give Johnson great coverage of closing the gap and breaking down the ball. Boss to get released just a little bit earlier, but again, North has had some chances for some big plays. It's just been a tad bit short.
But way left, right in front of us, is Ryan Steele. Stone drops back, looking for Steele. Oh, Steele gets banged up by a couple of Centennial Golden Hawks, and those North High coaches are all over the referees. And Brian, I don't know if you saw it, but Ryan Steele now jawing with those DBs from Centennial. Boy, he got banged up all the way down the field.
Yeah, Ryan still is a little upset that, you know, that he's getting knocked all the way down the field. But the one thing in high school football that you can do is like college, they can bump and push you all the way down the field. But once the ball's in there, they can't. And the only thing I can guess is they said the ball wasn't catchable. Because otherwise, like you said, man, that's a lot of contact.
Deep for the G-Hawks. Brian Putman, we know he's dangerous back there. It's a short kick. Look out. Look out. Ooh. He just swarms all over it because that had danger written on it.
Yeah, it did, man. I was like you. I was almost on the edge of our platform
up
here.
That was one of those vertical spirals.
And the way he dove it, you know, I seen that ball hit the guy's shoulder pad and bounce right to the defense, but he did a good job securing it.
That sharp young man was one of our guests as the young Woldridge athlete of the game a few weeks ago, and his presence off the field and on the camera was just as impressive and as intuitive as it is on the field. 2:53. Less than a half, first and 10 for the Golden Hawks. They're on their own 34-yard line. And in less than 3 minutes, they need to get in the end zone again. Pass out here to number 11, Braden Bowles. Braden Bowles takes some big hits, but he gets about 7 yards, and man, those pads are popping, B.
Yeah, Braden Bowles is fortunate that he wasn't closer into the, wasn't further into the field of play. That would have been a fumble and turnover for the Golden Hawks. You see right here, catches the ball. Stays with it, way to keep grounding the ball, and the right here is going to get good contact. You see the ball come loose. And I'm telling you, they've dodged two bullets tonight when that ball's on the ground for Centennial.
Stars hitting hard, second and three. Looks like they might show a blitz on the outside. Now not, they're going to hold up. Caprioli in motion. Morrell throws up on the upside. Look at this. Oh, goodness. Had the potential to be a really, really nice play. He launched it out to Caprioli, let him off his outside arm, but incomplete.
I'll tell you, Chris Lucero out there, I thought he had a chance, if he was paying attention, to really break on the ball.
Pick that thing off.
And that's one, when you're a corner, you see that ball float like that and a guy come out, you want to get a good break because you know if you can catch it, there's no way they're going to stop you from taking that to the house. There's nobody out there.
We got a shot at number three, the quarterback running on. It's third and three. We'll find out who our young Woldridge player of the game will be tonight. Here's Sparks. He battles, and I don't think he got it unless they gave him that last little roll, Brian. You never know. This would be a close call.
They gave it to him.
Wow.
They gave him the last little roll, all right.
I guess so. Maybe his knee had never touched. He just rolled off the pile and got a first down. But, man, that's a nice spot.
Does a good job of spinning once he gets the contact. And it's hard to tell, but it looked like he did, it was hard to tell from that angle.
Looked like his elbow landed right where it was first down, first and 10. 2:22 left in this first half. Nice ball game. Golden Hawks going against the North High School Stars on their own field. Morrell drops back across the middle. Wide open, Matt Smith. And looks like Matt could have run a faster route, but he knew. Wait right there in the pocket and catch it where it is.
Yeah, he's just going to run on the seam right there. And Morrell's job to make the read. He reads the safety. The safety's on the other side. Look how he's looking to the right. Looks off the safety. Comes back to his left. Throws a strike. And that's just a good pitching catch again.
That's a great camera coverage there. There are men on the field. I think that's Carlos down there. Muy bueno, señor. Nice, nice shot. First and 10. Under 2 minutes left in this first half. Golden Hawks in the neighborhood. Boy, they want to start knocking on the door and get another score here. Morrell fakes left, rolls right. Got a man open. Again, the same guy, Matt Smith. Looks like another first down.
Well, that's what they like to do. Coach Dixon loves that play action and rolling that tight end across the field on those little corner routes, and that's a big play in the Centennial arsenal. And they're in the field goal range now, so.
Yeah, but it's a big difference.
They have a minute and 41 now, Vance, where they can take a chance, at, I think, at trying to get a touchdown.
Big difference between points if they get a TD here. Chica, lone back. Morrell. Ball batted down out there. I believe it was number 40, Chase Hawkins, and he was hawking all right. And, hey, that's a big play. That just takes one less down away from the Golden Hawks trying to get this thing in the end zone.
Yeah, if the Golden Hawks, if you want to try to force a field goal attempt, you might be able to block, I mean, if it's a star. But right here, you're going to see Chase, he's getting blocked. Incomplete, and good technique. He knows to jump up, the ball's coming, and way to knock the ball down.
1:26 left in the first half. Golden Hawks.
Second and 10.
On the 15-yard line of North High School. They're up 3 right now. They'd like to go up 9, maybe 10. 3 receivers, way split left. Morrell's on a keeper. He runs up the gut. What a beautiful play. Touchdown.
Brett Morrell in for the touchdown.
Brian, you called it with your hand signals. You told me before the play unraveled exactly what was going to happen.
Yeah, there was just nobody in the middle of the field, man. They were all spread out, and that's just a great call right there by Coach Dixon and the staff. And again, good field position. They take advantage of it. They spread them out. There's nobody out there to count for the quarterback. And they just snap the ball and just do a quarterback keeper up the middle.
Score now is 16-7.
And just rolls in.
With an almost certainty, without hexing anybody, is Josh Bright's PAT. Snaps perfect, holds perfect, kicks perfect. That makes it 17-7. Brian, I had a chance to look over in the sidelines of North High School after TD was scored, and I saw Coach Stone grabbing his quarterback saying, hey, we got a buck 20 left, let's go.
Yeah, and with his arm, you know, that's not, they have enough time. They have timeouts left. But I think if they do get a chance to return the ball, they got to get a good return. Right here, this is just the quarterback keeping it, and you see there's just nobody in the middle, Vance. They go down, they block the two linebackers. All the receivers are being covered. They're all spread out, and there's nobody home.
Well, with exactly 1:20 left in this first half, Centennial up 10. Brian, got some big games tonight. I think we'll start getting down to like our 3. Like, what is the big 3 games we talk about? You know, because, you know, we just can't cover 19, 20 predictions. But your Drillers up at East High tonight, huge game, both 2-0.
Well, it's huge because BHS can't afford a letdown. You can't have that big win against Liberty and come back against East. I think overall, team-wise, they have too much for East. You know, you just can't win with one guy.
Tehachapi at Arvin. Both 4-3, both 2-0 in league. We haven't seen Tehachapi. We've seen Arvin.
Where's the game at?
At Arvin.
At Arvin. You know, I like the Bears in Arvin. If you tell me it's Tehachapi, I would take Tehachapi.
Our final game.
Kicking off
South at West.
Number 19.
Well,
Josh
with South
Bryant.
Having Davidson, I mean, West having Davidson step up. You never know what they're going to do offensively, but I like West against South in that one.
Well, I had thought that Ryan Steele
steps into the end zone. The ball will come out to the 20-yard line.
Tippy toe was in the end zone, and it was. He might have had a chance to run that back about 4 inches more towards the north, but it'll be first and 10 from the 20. Those are our predictions for our three games. We'll keep it at three.
We'll keep it at three. That sounds good. Now, I tell you, man, I think it was great that he didn't get a chance to run it because there was no way he's going to catch his wedge. The wedge was up at the 16-yard line. He's on the goal line, and Centennial was coming right around the wedge to make a play.
As we know, sometimes things happen for strange reasons. We'll talk about that right after this play. Stone throws out to the right side. Can't get out bounds, or can he? Willie, he does not get out of bounds. Clock will keep on rolling. That's number 82, Anthony Gonzalez. Like last week when I talk about things happening for strange reasons, Jay Williams returning the punt last week. Final chance
for
the Liberty Patriots. He slipped and the clock stopped. Had he stayed on his feet, the clock would have ran out.
Yeah, and the game would have been over and we would have never had that last play.
Second and one, as you may have heard from the loudspeaker right above us, Stone rolls left, throws left, and it's caught out there by Ryan Steele. Clock is still ticking. It is a first down. They'll stop for a second here, or will they? We're under 2 minutes. Looks like they're going to keep rolling.
Yeah, the clock is rolling, so.
And now it looks as if we'll have a timeout from North High School. And Coach Stone over there just waving his arms. He wants somebody to say, hey, call timeout.
Yeah, Coach Snow wants it. He needs a timeout if it's not stopping the clock for the chains to move. And they lost a good six, seven seconds, man.
Well, Brian, next week, Halloween, Ridgeview at Foothill, October 31st. The Wolf Pack way over there on the east side, southeast side of Foothill. Legendary grounds of Ned Permenter, and now got Douglas running the program. Ridgeview playing well. Got a super stud at UCLA this year. A Halloween game, my man, and that ought to be something. Both teams pretty well even matched. Should be a good one.
Yeah, I think it will.
Engel.
Yeah, Engel's going to be there. And I think Foothill has a good chance tonight to get their first win. And if they don't do it tonight, I think they have a good chance to win. Against Ridgeview. Should be a good game, good battle between those two.
Join us next week for that. And then our final game of the regular season, before we start playoffs, it'll be East at Highland. Leandre Matthews will be the featured athlete for his final high school game in league. Never know what will happen for playoffs, and then we'll get into three playoff games.
10 weeks, that's fast already.
Man, we're in the eighth week now, man.
And I know you're happy with this warm weather because you've been able to stay.
I didn't bring my jacket tonight,
you've been able to stay shirtless for a long time.
I'm being taken to task. Cody Stone rolls right. And then, Brian, what we're talking about is our final Friday night game in league will be East at Highland. And then our final game of the league season will be a big one. That'll be on Saturday right after that. We'll talk about that in a moment. 17 seconds. Clock is ticking. North High School trying to get in field goal range. Cody Stone throws out here, and it's a nice play. Was it caught? No, it's incomplete. Well, the clock stops, and it'll stop at 9 seconds. So, Brian, I'm going to clarify something. Our final game will be East at Highland on Friday night of our league play. Our final league game will be the next day. We're going to be traveling up the 99 for the Shafter-Wasco rivalry. Here's Cody Stone.
Again, I like the way Cody throws the ball. You know, it's hard to see from our angle if he ever had it, but the referee ruled it down, so they're going to probably have one play to try to get it down there and maybe get out of bounds and try to have a chance to stop the clock.
Stone rolls left, killing a lot of seconds. It's already down to, let's see, does he get out of time? In time, the clock says no, let's see. I thought there was a second, ref say no.
At least one.
Wow, let's see. Let's see, they're keeping the Centennial players on.
And the referee's doing a good job of letting them know that because it should be at least 1 second. Well, great job by the officiating crew.
Excellent job by our officials here. I saw 1 second, Brian saw 1 second, the North High School sideline saw 1 second, and Coach Stone had 1 second up, so it is 1 second. 17-7, Hawks, the G-Hawks, that is, lead by 10. Last play of the game, and last play of the half, sorry about that, North High at the 51-yard line as far as distance is concerned. Cody Stone drops back, and he'll get taken for a loss, and that'll wrap up the first half. So the Golden Hawks were scored on first, but they came back and scored 17 unanswered points. That's the score right there at halftime. I'm Vance Palm. We've got Brian Adams next to me. Back in a moment at halftime. Great ball game out here in a big battle for league dominance. We'll be right back.
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woodridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woodridge. Integrity you can trust.
Does this happen in your house?
Hey, Dad, where are those videos from last year's birthday?
Hallway closet. Taking up all the room.
There is a brighter way. Bright House Network's duplication services can help you edit all those home videos into your own personal family blockbuster. And when you're done, put it all on DVD so the memories will last forever. Bright House Networks also makes it easy to duplicate, repair, and transfer video to any format. Call today. Your memories are worth it.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous South Rock favorites. Listen at work. Listen at home. Listen in the car. The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
You're watching the Golden Hawk Marching Band led by Ashley Tomas.
End of this quarter, we'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No. Look.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woodridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woodridge. Integrity you can trust.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous South Rock favorites. Listen at work. Listen at home.
Listen in the Car. The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Presents the High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by the Law Offices of Young Woodridge, Rusty's Pizza, and KERN News Talk 1410.
Welcome back, Bright House Network subscribers. Hello, Kern County football fans. Welcome back. Can you believe it? We're going into the third quarter here. Golden Hawks up 10, 17-7 over North High School. North High School will be getting the football right now at the beginning of the third quarter. Really nice football game. This kick is short. It'll be taken by Ryan Steele at the 10-yard line. Steele looking for a big gap. Gets knocked back about 4 yards from his own player who was getting blocked and just turns into trouble after that. And for all that work, it's about the 17-yard line. Ryan, North High School. Started off with a bang, got in the end zone early, then gave up 17 straight points. Now it's all about earning that respect right now, winning this ball game.
Yeah, it is, and this is how you win it. Win the tough ones. You're on the road, you're behind. This is when you've got to kind of suck it up and just somehow, some way, you got to figure out a way to pull it out. And if it's Centennial, I just think you got to do what you do best and just dominate the line, wear down your opponent, and keep the game in your favor.
Hand off to the right side, Bryson Hoppe. Hoppe picks up one. Well, Kern County, you never want to hope too much, but I think we might have some pretty cool third quarter guests up here. Maybe. We'll see. We'll keep the cat in the bag or the cat in the hat or whatever it is until we can maybe have them all up here. We thought we'd get David Carrillo. We hope we do. We might have some more guests. Look at this. Steele kicks out again. This time Centennial closed things off, but a nice cut back upfield by Jason Morris. Maybe he only picks up two or three, but kept his wits about him and just cut across the grain.
Yeah, that's the same kind of little option pitch play they ran earlier. They were able to pick up a big gain.
An injured player down there. Looks like it might be Coleman Sowers. Is that number six I see? Yeah, it is.
That's what I'm thinking too, man.
Coleman Sowers, a 5'9", 165-pound senior, plays running back, linebacker.
Today in the Southwest Yosemite Tennis Tournament at the varsity level.
And right here, we see on the Rusty replay,
in singles competition,
cutting back, and you see Sowers, he's just underneath, and the way just kind of landed on kind of awkwardly right there.
Brittany Omberg.
And Jason Morrison cutting the ball back across the grain.
And fourth place, Ashley Hegman. Congratulations, ladies.
And he's rocking a little tender on that leg right there. So
we'd like to congratulate Jennifer Pryor.
Hope that he's going to be able to be okay.
Well, there's kind of a rippling applause. Some of it is for Coleman Sowers for making his way off the field. And appreciation of his hard efforts and also for the tennis team being announced here by the public address announcer.
Congratulations, ladies.
So, we're back to third and five. Stone drops back, throws out to the left. He's got a receiver. Again, he hits Anthony Gonzalez. Anthony Gonzalez gets another first down for the North High School Stars, and it's been a nice combo tonight.
Well, I'll tell you, one route advance has really worked well for the North Stars, this out route. And the reason why it can work, because you got a really strong on curve quarterback. You've seen the rest of the replay. Cody Stone throws the out. Gonzalez is able to catch it and not elude the defender, but he's able to pick up a first down.
First and 10, North High School. They're on their own 34-yard line. The ball goes up the middle. Jerry White, 5'10", 230-pound senior, linebacker, fullback. Jerry White, integral part of this offense squad.
Yeah, he is, because when he's rolling hard up the middle like that, it opens everything else up for Hoppe and the other guys involved. And also opens the passing game for Stone and Steele and Gonzalez.
Second and eight.
Just underway here in the third quarter. You're watching Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. This is Vance Palmer. I've got Brian Adams next to me. Second and eight, North High School. Stone rolls. Decides to pitch it. He does pitch it. gets maybe about 3 or 4 yards as Bryson Hoppe catches that pitch and get the feeling that North High really needs to get one going here.
Yeah, they do, man, because, you know, the one thing that's going to be against them, the clock is moving fast. Right here, you can see a pitch right there by Stone, the Hoppe. Hoppe gets outside, but Hoppe does a good job of coming up from that secondary corner position and securing the tackle and keeping the short of the first down.
Third and four. Pretty big first down early in the third quarter. The pass is out to the wing, and Putman was over there covering, and a really nice pass, maybe a little high out there for Ryan Steele. I thought it might have a chance of being picked off.
Yeah, it was a little high and a little late. Right here, the ball's got to go. Hold the ball a little too late on that play right there, waiting for the receiver. And you can see if it was thrown any lower, though, I think Putman has his second interception for a touchdown. But I'll tell you, man,
go ahead, go
ahead. But they're going to set him up. They're going to have an out and up open on that sideline. They're going to throw me out. I wouldn't be surprised to see that out and up.
Keep that in mind. Right now it's 4th and 4. North will punt. Putman deep for the Golden Hawks on his own 30-yard line.
Yep.
Brian, I almost can't believe it. It looked like they were going to run a fake punt in the second back up there with a blocking fake to hard count. What happened is the center snapped it, caused the punter to go down on a knee, and
on the 25
ouch.
Yeah, you'll see right here, the punter goes down the knees. He drops it right there, and in high school football, college football, the play is over. He's down, and that's worse than a turnover right there, Vance.
Brian, are they coached to get down as low as they possibly can and scoop it without their knee touching?
Well, I imagine they are, but, you know, sometimes it's just a natural reaction. You know,
I asked that as a novice.
The snap is kind of low. You go down trying to secure the catch, and sometimes you just go down.
Right. You don't want the ball going in the end zone.
Yeah, tough play.
Well, all of a sudden, just like that, it's 1st and 10 Golden Hawks. Oh, a dangerous play. It's a pitch pass, and unless this pass is dropped, it's just a really misty play. And touchdown pass from J.P. Masuda to Jason Caprioli, and it was almost botched, but it wasn't, and it's a TD.
Right there, you know, one bad break for North, a good break for Centennial. They almost botched a pitch fake, a reverse to the receiver. Seaver picks it up, and like you said, Vant, throws an easy strike right there from Masuda to Caprioli, and Caprioli's wide open. And I like that call by Coach Nixon. You know, you're in attack mode, you get a turnover, great field position, go for it, you know, because you're going to count your defense not giving up a lot of points. And I tell you, I said in the pregame they had to get 24, and I think they're going to get it with this extra point here.
One of these threes ringing true. Oh, a high snap. Now they just have to kind of do what they have to do. But Caprioli looks, flips it out. Can you believe this? Might have got taken in by Chris, not Chris Chicka. That was Garrett Cheatwood. Cheatwood couldn't get it in. And as you were asking for the 24th for the B's three, they don't get it. But let's take a look at this touchdown here. Here comes J.P. Masuda, Brian. He's launches it up.
And the thing about Masuda, you know, there's a lot of pressure on you when there's a man wide, wide open. And you got to make that throw. So he does a good job of getting the ball out there. Caprioli secures the catch and walks in the end zone.
Remember Steve Sachs for the Dodgers? He'd catch those easy grounders. He'd be like 10 feet away from first base, and he just couldn't get the throw there. They go through that disease.
Yep.
You know,
knob lock for the Yankees had a problem with
so
that.
So here comes Masuda around the corner. He's got Caprioli with nobody around him. Sometimes you can think, oh, it gets mental. It's all mental, right?
Yeah, it is.
It's all mental. That brings up another situation where the North High School Stars are going to get the ball, but it's only because of a score from Centennial. They get it on the receiving end of a kick, and they'd like to be getting it on turnovers or having Centennial punt, but here it is, 23-7. Centennial kicking off again. North High School Stars started off with a bang, and I mean, they just marched right down the field, Kern County. And they haven't been in since.
Yeah, they had everything working on all cylinders in that first series, and they haven't since. But that's what a good defense can do. A good defense comes on and make adjustments, man. They see that you're doing things to them, and then they turn it around and they take things away. I think North now has to go into a passing situation. They get the ball up the field.
Whoa. That right there was a really risky. That was a close play right there. Anthony Goodwin was about to receive that kick, and it was a short kick. It was kind of a a pitching wedge, and it bounced, and it was going to take one more bounce, and if that ball bounced in, Centennial was going to pounce on it, but it bounced out.
Well, I'll tell you, that's probably the first big break that North has got to see, because they're going to put the ball on 35, which is their second best field position of the night, and the first time they had the best field position they scored, so they're going to have to crank it up now and get that high-powered offense in the end zone.
Ryan Steele, split way right, wasn't even in the huddle. Stone drops right. Throws out there a nice pass caught out there by Jason Morris. Jason Morris makes a good move, hops over a couple tacklers, and gets out to the Centennial 45-yard line.
To Jason Morris.
Well, I'll tell you, fans, I like this right here. Well, I like two of them getting rid of the ball. He's getting his back foot, steps up, fires the ball into the flats right there. Morris catches the ball, cuts it upfield, and you get Steele coming back, blocking for him. And they'll pick up the first down. Now I would stay with that passing package and get in and out the huddle like they do and keep rolling it.
Stone decides to keep, cuts up field, gets about 4 yards, and they're four tough yards. Brian, you're on the North High sidelines. You're the coaching staff. You're thinking about combination mixtures, if you will, about this powerful offense. Still have a lot of confidence in what you got going?
Well, yeah, you still have some time. You got 8 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter, but you got to put something on the board. You got to put a field goal, a touchdown. You need some positive points in this drive.
Well, Anthony Gonzalez, not in the huddle either. That's by design, of course. They've been going to him, so he's out right. Let's see what happens. In motion is Steele. Steele on the quick inside handoff. Steele cuts up field. Ooh, try to make one last cut for a TD. It did get him a first down, and as you just mentioned, you know, they've got the tools. Let's just put it together.
Yeah, and Steele gives him the ability to have that nimble, quick movement, the ability to make the quick moves, and he just slipped right there. But he's a guy that you want to get the ball. He's like Matt Mason and some of these other juku, where you can get them out in space. They can make a guy, one or two guys missing the speed, they can make a big play for you, maybe a touchdown.
First and 10, Stars. Stone drops back, throws it across the middle. Complete out there to number 82, Anthony Gonzalez. Yes, he did take a big hit. You might have heard that all the way over on the east side. But
made some serious plastic on that one.
Wow. Man. Hey, Kern County, great play. Great catch. Hit.
Yeah, good pass and catch. And then right here, Horak comes in and knocks him. Hits him so hard, knocks him back towards the goal line.
Wow, even his fellow defender Putman said, man, what a hit. I felt that. Stone, option, cuts up field. Centennial really is such a well-coached team on defense that an option against them is, you know, not the easiest thing in the world to do.
No, because you might get a big run like they did earlier, but there's not going to be many of them because they adjust really well. And again, they're just well-coached. You know, they keep the techniques and they string you out. Like I said, they don't have the most speed going laterally, but they don't have to because they play such good techniques on the line and the linebacker, so they make it just really tough for you to find places to run outside on them.
7:15 left in the third quarter. Double handoff, up the gut. What a gorgeous play. Jason Morris is the final running back that has his ball handed off, and boy, I sure hope we get a replay of this shot. This is really nice stuff right here.
This is what they do when they get these wing formations. You know, they're going to fake one away. Another guy's coming in. Morris comes in. He gets it. But I like what they're doing up the middle. That's where they had success on that first series, up the middle.
This North High School crowd starting to get into it. Here's the name we know. Look at this. Jerry White pounds his way in. Touchdown, North High School.
I tell you, you know, he and Chad Sorrell, man, in my opinion, are two of the best runners inside the tackle. I mean, when they get going north and south and rolling, they are hard to tackle.
We see Mitch Horak getting up kind of slow. I don't think he's hurt, but, boy, he put his heart and soul into that drive, and North just kept bringing it. Here's a shot of the Centennial coaching staff. There's head coach Nixon, and he's talking to somebody down there about something. What we do know is it's 23-13, and let's not forget, PAT missed earlier.
We talked about that. Now it's a big play last week in Liberty's loss.
And look at this. Okay, seemed to be a bit of a confusing tale out here, but we will be going for the PAT if you're North High School. Parker Reynolds. Wow, shaky hold there, and it's up, and it's good. So it's a 9-point ball game. The ever funky 9-point lead in football.
That odd point, in some way, somehow, the time just coming back and biting you. But I tell you, this might be the ultimate lift the defense needed to get pumped up. And you see right there, I mean, that's just White just desired. I mean, he's going 1-on-4 there. And these guys he's going against are great defenders. They just don't do that. People don't do that to him often. So you got to give White great effort and applause in that run.
Jerry White, 5'10", 230-pounder. We talked about him 2 weeks ago in that powerful offense that North High has and will continue to have. I'll tell you what, Brian, you know, that 9-point lead in football is like a it's almost like a 2-point lead in the hoop. You know, if you got a 3-point lead, somebody buries a 3-pointer, you're still tied, you know. But it's like, you know what I mean. 9-point lead. It's still a 9-point lead, though, and now Centennial gets the ball. They want to build on it. Here's the kick. It's a knuckleballer. It's fielded at the 11-yard line by Putman. Putman gets another nice run.
And I tell you, that's been a big help for Centennial. As they're returning, they're getting the ball out there. He's got a short field to go. And I think, you know, you get the momentum going, and then Putman's a good job. Again, look how close he is to his blockers. This allows him to get in there and to crack. And that's something we haven't seen other return teams do. And again, they're just well coached on every facet of the ball game, special teams, defense, the offense. And I think that's why they're so successful.
Not many chinks in the armor for the Golden Hawks. Caprioli in motion. He's running east. Sparks picks up the handoff. Tries to get outside. Sparks can't get away from some pesky North Star defensive players. Chris Lucero, one of them. Didn't catch the other number, but I certainly want to give it out to number 34. He chased him down, and if I'll see it on our Bright House Network, we'll mention it there.
Yeah, Chris Lucero, he did a good job of coming up from that secondary and making the tackle, as you said. And Scott Allison also forced him to go wide to give Lucero a chance to get there and make the tackle.
So Sparks is quick, you know, and he's a junior. We haven't talked a lot about Sparks tonight, but big factor in this offense. Chica in motion. Sparks alone back, and he does get the carry. He goes up the middle, looks for holes, almost gets stripped, doesn't. Now he battles ahead for another 3 or 4 yards, makes it a 12-yard run. Brian, that's
second effort, picking up a first down.
Why say anything? He just did it himself. He can speak for himself.
Yeah, you know, he hits the hole hard. What I like about Sparks is ability when he gets the ball. That guy hits the hole hard. He makes a cut in the hole. But again, they spread him out. This is the same play, except for he's running, except for Morrell, they scored on. They're spreading him out with the receivers, and there's nobody in the middle of the defense.
First and 10, Golden Hawks. They're on the north 45. Morrell, either errant or wisely, just kind of threw it off to the right flank. And the Golden Hawks, coached by Brian Nixon, the head coach. Assistant coaches Ryan Renz, Dave Rice, Richard Parrott, Rick Tucker. Their trainer is Tom Dennison. Filmer is Kurt Eknoyan. Staffs are done by Claude Bradford and, of course, the principal, Dave Olds, and athletic director, Gary Fowler. The Golden Hawks, what a program, Brian.
Yeah, they have a great program, not just in football, but their whole sports program is very well run, and they've got a lot of school support.
Second and 10, 5.5 left in the third quarter. Morrell behind center, eye formation, fakes, rolls right. He's got all kinds of pressure all over him. He launches one out and just ends up in no man's land. It was intended for Caprioli, but with the pressure that Burrell was under, he just did the right thing and threw it out into safe territory.
Yeah, I think he just threw it away. I don't know if he was trying to throw it to anybody on that.
I don't either.
I think if he tried to throw that ball to Caprioli, that's going to be an interception because he was covered by at least 3 stars. But
who was putting the pressure on there? Did you see who?
Yeah, I couldn't see the number there, but it was great pressure by the front five right there, four of the North High Stars. But here's the situation, man. I think this is a big play. They can get the ball back with 5 minutes in the third quarter. They can march down again and get this to a 3-point game.
Shotgun, third and 10. Morrell floats one out. This could be anybody's ball. And it is. Anthony Gonzalez with the pick. Anthony Gonzalez now trying to cut back upfield. It's North High School football. Hey, Kern County, can you hear that North High crowd from your living room?
And old Mr. Lowe, man, he's starting to move. He's starting to move. Again, the ball's up this time. Gonzalez on the corner, he's able to see the ball, find it. Does a good job of going up for the ball, not waiting on it. And then turns into a return man and gives the North High Stars good field position.
That's Anthony Gonzalez, 6'3", 175-pound senior. He's a wide receiver, but he also is a DB, obviously, and he's made some big plays tonight. Stone rolls left, sets up, rolls. Ooh. Boy, that was a hard throw, and I mean hard with velocity.
I think it might be a late hit. Yes,
look
it
out.
Is.
Look out, Kern County. Late. Late hit on the Golden Hawk.
Well, roughing the quarterback, they're going to call, but hit the quarterback late.
Well, we'll get the verbiage correct here. Roughing the quarterback, which is in essence a late hit with a different twist on it.
Yeah, you got to protect the quarterback. And it's so, a personal, that's 15 yards, and those are things we haven't talked about, but they'd be a big difference. A big tone like that keeps that momentum going, picks up 15 yards, and now in your territory attacking you.
Up the middle, the big fella. Jerry White.
And Vance, the middle's been open for him. And I like the fact that they haven't abandoned the middle, and they're going right back to it. And Jerry White is telling that middle, and now they're getting a chance to wear down that Centennial defense and what Centennial offense does the other team.
Stone. Play action. Rolls right. Throws it out, and
another 15 yards.
No, Brian, I think it actually was defensive interference. I think he was interfering in the play. I don't know if he called it actually on the push out of bounds.
He's gonna call this. Watch this, man. He's gonna call it a personal foul.
I thought he actually was. Tonight. I thought he was holding his arm. Wow.
Personal foul against Centennial.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at this Rusty's replay, Brian. Bright House Network crew doing their job.
Just rolling out a Rusty's replay. Throws the ball out. And we don't have it happens out of our camera angle, but that's what we're calling. They're just calling the push on Cornelson after the play.
So Kern County, the call was that after the pass was ruled incomplete, or as it was going to be ruled incomplete, non-catchable, there was unnecessary roughness or personal foul, shoved the guy in the back, hit Jerry White, knocked him out of bounds, and unnecessary roughness is the definition that I like to go by, but that was certainly was a personal foul.
Yeah, I think
it was rough and it was unnecessary.
Yeah, they just call unsportsmanlike conduct or I don't know, but those are two things you normally don't see a Centennial ball club do.
So if you're a prize fighter, you're Centennial,
blows,
right, and you're up against the ropes all of a sudden. Look at this, first and 10, North High, 48 on the first stone. Pitches out, wow. Jason Moore had to put his glove on that one, and those pitches are making me nervous.
Yeah, they are. Like I said, man, there's just not much out there against that Centennial defense with the ability to be able to spread out. And you see, Houston comes to the quarterback. And you see right there the pitch man's being taken out so by Eric Minnis. So he comes up from a safety to get the pitch man. So I mean, that's a real, that's a defense, a little movement.
Well, unfortunately, Darren Thomas, 6-footer, 200-pound senior tight end on the left side here, just moved a little too early, right in front of the Centennial bench. So obviously when they see it, they're all yelling, hey, movement, movement, movement. But the ref happened to be standing right there as well. So
you get two breaks to go your way, and then you don't take advantage of them. You run an option play that really, there hasn't been much out there on that option play for you all night. And then you get a penalty for movement.
And quirky things could happen. Now this maybe causes a change in play calling, and you just never know. Second and 15, 3:45 left in the third quarter. Both sides of this football field are loud and rambunctious. North High crowd is up, Centennial crowd is up, and that gets maybe 3 yards. That brings up third and long, and we got ourselves a ball game, Brian.
Yeah, we do. But here's a situation where you can run that out and up. I'm telling you, man. That out and up, especially with Putman, because Putman is going on the out play. He's throwing so many, he's a good aggressive corner. He's looking to get picked. So if he's going to break on that out, you might want to go out and up to that first pylon on that goal line if you can get your quarterback time.
Third and 12.
off the emotion. Stone drops back, looking to get a man open. Can he? He cannot. He's going for a loss. Brian, here's our Rusty's replay.
I just said you're going to have something open. It still was open, but there's just not enough time. By the time he's ready to throw, you got Horak coming in his face. And Chiefwood there, so they are able to thwart that play, so it's going to be a big fourth down play they're going for now.
Clock ticking in the third quarter, 2:34, 2:33. Quarterback Cody Stone runs on to the field to see his North High School teammates. Anthony Gonzalez, foot right. Fourth and 17, they'll go for it, and it's loud. Pop the emoji, Stone rolls right. Stone, a lot of time, but now he's got to try to outrun some running linebackers, and he can't do it. Another testament to this great defensive backfield for the Golden Hawks.
Yeah, right there, everybody's covered. I mean, they know you have to go, 15, 16, 17 yards, so they just kind of sat back and waited for you. We got another penalty flag on the field. And they come to him with grounding.
Well, he was in the grasp of a linebacker, and it maybe caused him to throw a little weak to the right, but there was nobody there anyway.
Well, he must not have gotten out of the tackle box. Right here, he's going to set up, and he wants to go deep. Gonzalez is covered, so he didn't have it there. Covered, played by the cover. Now he's trying to get out, and they're just saying he didn't get out of the tackle, and throws him to the grounding right there. So Ralston does a good job of keeping him in containment, and look at this Golden Hawk field position.
First and 10 from the North High School, 47-yard line. Golden Hawks at home, 31-0 in league. Now the ball goes to Sparks. Sparks is met hard and heavy.
Well, I tell you, fans, we haven't had much noise going on early in the game, but they are yelling on both sides of the ball now, and we're seeing both defenses step up. And again, we've got to see who's going to be able to pull it out in this game. But, Centennial's going to get back and just try to drive the ball and try to eat that clock up.
At the beginning of the fourth quarter, we'll have a very special guest with us. He's up here now. You're going to want to hear from this cat we've got up here. 1:34 left in the third quarter. What a ball game. Second and 10 for the Golden Hawks. Morrell has an eye formation behind him, but he drops straight back. He's in trouble, too. Look out. Flag on the play. Brian, you think it might be holding, so
yeah,
it could be...
But they'll decline that anyway. That's in the holding zone.
In on the stop.
Here's our call from our top guy.
Holding penalty against Centennial.
And they should decline that one. It'll be third and long.
Here's our Rusty's replay on what was going to be a big loss no matter what, Brian.
Yeah, it is. And right here, Rusty's going to try to set back. And he just has no time right here. By the time he's ready to set, you got pressure in there, and I can't see who it's from. Looks like Chase. It is Chase Hawkins on the play, so great defensive play by the Stars right there. You know, this situation, sometimes you just see those teams run that little draw play, punt the ball, advance, and let the defense hold them.
The scoreboard says third and 20. It's about third and 26 with 1:09 left in this third quarter. North High School trying to get a big turnover here. The ball is floated up again, and this time it's caught by Caprioli. Well, Brian, third and awfully long, and that ball seemed to be floating up there for a lifetime, but guess what? It comes down in the hands of number eight. A huge first down here is our Rusty's replay.
Well, right here, you know, the secondary player has to make a play. The ball's up there for him to knock it out, but he just misjudges it. And Caprioli gets behind him, which can't let happen. And hauls in the catch, secures it, and keeps it until Golden Hawks moving. Big third down pickup.
Morrell barking to the sidelines. Hey, where's my fullback? Or my halfback? Where is Sparks? He runs on the field. Morrell decides to keep it. Had to get a playoff. Smart play. Sparks wasn't out on the field. And with 51 seconds left, that brings up second and, you know, doggone it, Centennial gets 4 yards off that, so second and six. That clock is ticking. When we come back, the beginning of the fourth quarter, my special guest. Might as well just tell you now, Golden Hawks legend, Chris Houston. Multi-sport star here for the Golden Hawks. Last year, one of our young Wooldridge player of the game. Every time I opened the newspaper in the spring, he'd hit another dinger and knocked it out of some neighborhood. Chris Houston, our guest in the fourth quarter. Right now, Goldenhawks. Capriola in motion. Morrell, hard count. Drops straight back. Looks to his left. Capriola stops on a button hook.
Pass complete to Jason Capriola.
He gets the first down. Clock is running. Haven't stopped at 0-0-6 now to move the chains. There's a shot of Chris's younger brother Ryan there on the sideline. Ryan, here's our Rusty's replay. It was all Morrell Capriola.
Yeah, Morrell's going to set up, gets his fifth step, drops back, throws the hook. Capriola did a good job of catching the ball and stays in bounds. Picks up the first down. And they're going to sort of let it
hey,
go.
Hey, that's the final play of the third quarter. When we return for the fourth quarter, not only do we have a Super Bowl game, we've got Chris Houston. We're going to talk to him. I'm Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. Hey, thanks, KERN 1410 News Talk. We want to thank you, Young Woldridge, and of course, Rusty Spitzer back with a killer fourth quarter in just a moment.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No. Look.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza. On time, every time.
Yeah! Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woldridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woldridge. Integrity you can trust.
Well, Kern County, we're back to get into the fourth quarter. First and goal from the 7-yard line. The Golden Hawks having a little bit of a chat out there. And momentarily, we're going to get to hear from Chris Houston. Chris Houston, last year, one of our Young Woldridge athletes of the game at BHS, and a huge game for the Golden Hawks. But right now, talk about huge, big play for the North High School defense. Or a big series right here, right now. Morrell hands the ball out to Sparks. Sparks tripped up, tries to cut outside, can't do it. Run down out there by Scott Allison. That brings up second and 7. Well, Chris, pleasure to have you with us. First of all, back on campus, welcome back. Chris, we got a great chance to watch you last year. Have a great time of football and baseball. You're really just a stellar athlete. Tell Kern County what you're doing now, Chris Houston.
Right now I'm up in BC playing baseball up there, and I really enjoy it. It's going well, and I like coming here to Centennial, watch the younger guys play. It's good to come back and watch a good program like Centennial and know that you were a part of it one time. So just as of right now, I'm just up in BC playing baseball, having a good time.
Morrell. Almost to put another TD pass there, Brian. He's really got a gun.
Yeah, he does. And what I like about him is he's accurate with it, and I think that's the main thing. We haven't seen him throw any interceptions, really, this year. Maybe with us one tonight, but he doesn't turn the ball over. He can run the ball, beat with his arm or his legs, and right there he almost threw another strike.
Chris, as you're watching these guys get huddled up for a big 3rd and 8, do you miss football?
Oh, I miss it completely. These Friday nights are unbelievable. I wouldn't trade them for anything in the world, but it gets down to these points, like right here, that makes it so exciting.
3rd and 8, Golden Hawks. Morrell looks right, throws across left. Capriola catches it. Capriola makes one big move. And gets very, very close to the end zone. Doesn't get in. Brian, will that be 4th? It will be 4th down.
Well, I'll tell you, with the situation, looks like they're going to go for it right there. Looks like they're putting the power package in. They're going to just line up straight up and see if North can stop them.
That's the voice of Brian Adams. Watch our Rusty's replay. Cap really takes a big, big hit in there by Anthony Goodman, but he stays on his feet. I've got Chris Houston up here next to me. All three of us watching this one. Let's see what happens. 4th and goal from the 2. Morrell hands the ball up the middle to number 42. Are you kidding me? Who else would you give it to but Curtis Cornelson? He pounds it through. Golden Hawks up 29-14. This Seahawks crowd pretty fired up. Well, that's the big one right there, Vance, because now put the situation where they have to score a touchdown and conversion just to tie you. So if they can get the all elusive, which has been elusive this last situation, that's the point.
Well, this kid's got a leg. My other partner up here, Houston, can tell you about that. Josh Bright might kick this all the way to 7th and Standard. It's up, and it's good. 30-14, so it's a 16-point lead. Chris, one final question before we go. Your experience at a BC so far, it's a junior college, a lot of athletes that have a ton of talent such as yourself make decisions to kind of hold off on leaving town, even though you got a lot of offers. Tell us about your time at a BC so far.
BC's great. Coach Payton up there does a great job running the program, and the coaches are wonderful. I've learned more in the last, 4 months than I have probably in the last couple years. It's really a good experience, and I'm glad I did what I did, and I'm real excited for the season. We look like we got a good squad this year, and hopefully we'll come out and play, and hopefully we'll get some support from Bakersfield, and I think we'll be excited to see a team play like we're going to play this year. So,
what position did you play? So we know where to look for you next year.
Catching up at Centennial BC this year. We got quite a few good players, but as of right now, I'm catching, and I really enjoy it.
We had Jeff Crosby up here a few weeks back. He said he's coming back to play. Is that right?
Oh, good old Jeff. One of my best friends I've had for a long time. You never can tell what the guy's going to do, but if that's what he decides to do, I'm really happy for him. He's a great kid, great athlete, and I'd really love to see him here back in town.
That's the voice of Chris Houston. Chris, thanks for your time. Brian and I appreciate that. Best of luck, buddy.
Thanks, Chris.
Hey, that's Chris Houston, Kern County. Hope you enjoy that. His brother Ryan out here playing as a junior. He's got 2 years of football and baseball. Wow. Dad Mike Houston, longtime, well-known Kern County athlete. And Grandma Lee, sure hope you enjoyed that interview with Chris Houston. Want to keep that as a surprise for you. Hey, Kern County High School football, a lot of great families involved in it, don't they, Brian?
Oh, yeah. That's what makes Bakersfield a special place, is you get to know these families, these names, and as they go through generation to generation.
Well, the kickoff was a looked like a 2-iron. It was screaming down a really wet fairway in the morning, just kept skidding along, and it got caught up there by Anthony Gonzalez. And Brian, if you're North High School right now, there's just no getting around it. You got to get on down the field.
Well, yeah, now you kind of lose your luxury of having to be able to pound that ball, because you have to score quickly, because you want to get the ball back and score again, and you have to go for 2-point conversions both times. So the clock is against them, but like you said, Vance, they're looking for respect, and if they can drive down and come back and tie this game up and send overtime or win it, they'll definitely get a lot of respect in the area.
Stone drops back, throws out to the left to Ryan Steele. Ryan Steele, if he breaks that tackle, it's a touchdown, but can't do that. That's Brian Putman. Nice tackle out there, and literally that was a touchdown-saving tackle. Nobody behind him.
Yeah, it is, because with Steele's speed, when he hits the sideline, there's not a player on the Golden Hawks team that I believe can catch him with that short of an angle. As you see right there, Steele makes the turn, just kind of slips, but Putman's right there to wrap him up. Does a good job of also keeping from getting the first down.
Clock ticking, 9:55. Second and one. Steele in motion. Looks like he might throw. He fakes the throw, or doesn't have a place to throw it, and picks up the first down. And that's nice, because if that play is designed for him to throw and he practices the throw, he wants to throw, but he pulled it in and got a first down.
Well, Anthony Gonzalez is running out and up, but the out and up was against Johnson, and Johnson's not as aggressive as Putman, so you got to know which corner you're going to run out and up on, because Putman is the one you want to run it on. You're going to run on somebody because he's more aggressive. Johnson plays a little further off the ball in a safer type of corner, but he's also a good corner as well.
First and 10. Who's going to be our young Woodridge player of the game? I have no idea.
Cody Stone to pass.
Stone with a great play fake. Now launches it up. Can this be caught, or will it be picked off? And it is. Look at this.
Pass intercepted by Eric Manise.
Eric Manise with a very, very big interception. Well played, Brian.
Yeah, it was. And right there again, Cody Stone's under pressure, and he's just trying to make a play. And Manise playing safety. And does a good job of getting deeper than the receiver and makes an interception right here. As you'll see, he's coming up. He's doing a good job of being behind the receiver. Keeps everything in front of him. The ball's overthrown. He goes up, catches it.
He's
able to pick up and make a big turnover and get the ball back to the offense. And let him work on this clock, man.
9:14 left in the ballgame. I don't think this thing will be in the air. It is not. It's up the gut, and of the many options that they have, that one was Chris Chica, 5'10", 220-pound junior. Chica. As that clock starts ticking, Brian, if you're North High School, you start thinking about that opposing team going 32-0. The only thing you can do is try to catch him in 8:45.
Well, you better not be thinking about that. You better be thinking about trying to get a turnover or force and a quick punt.
Well, exactly that, trying to catch him. Second and 7. Norrell, option, keeps it. No chance. Doesn't try the pitch. No chance of a fumble. But that brings up a 3rd and 7.
Yeah, and that's a smart play by Morrell right there. You know, you don't need to make a pitch to make a big play. Clock's on your side. But right here, this is where, you know, Centeno run that little safe pass play. You'll see the little tight end dragging out. Caprioli rolling that hook and try to make that secure pass play and not take any chance of going way down the field.
3rd and 10. 8 minutes on the mark. Left in this game. Morrell has Chica behind him. They do pass. Morrell across the middle. It's a bullet. Todd Nunez, touchdown, Centennial.
And that's going to be it right there, man. You know, and I know it's a lot of times at 7:44, but I doubt the Centennial defense is going to give up, 16, 23 points in 7 minutes. So that right there was a huge play right there. That was kind of nailing the coffin, third down, and about 8 or 9, and you give up a big touchdown on a slant. And you can see right there the North High girl.
Well,
not looking good for the Stars.
Right, with the extra point. It's up. It's good. That makes it 37-14. Brian, as you say, it's a lot of points to make up. Here's our TD, just a bullet right across the middle of Todd Nunez.
Yeah, and that's just one of those little skinny posts right there to Nunez. He does a good job of catching the ball and running through the tackle there. And right then, there's nobody in the secondary that can go catch him. And like I said, that's going to be ball game for the Centennial right there.
Man, he just took a hard left and aimed for the cone. And North High School now has its hands full here with 7:44 left in this big ball game for dominance in the league. Well, Brian, you and I really wouldn't know about this up here in the booth. I mean, I can hear my stomach growling and grumbling right now as I'm trying to steal that payday from you on the console. But we will tell you that our Bright House Network's production crew, Director Bernie, Zach, all the fellas, they did rate tonight's tasty tri-tip from Centennial High School a solid 5 out of 5, a wow 5 out of 5. I can only dream and wish and hope that someday I'll get some of that, but a 5-star tri-tip rating.
Yeah, they have
the Centennial crowd as I drool over that payday you have.
And they are thankful for those that tri-tip.
Well, payday does sponsor Kevin Harvick on the Busch series, so we've got our pluses. Another special hello out there to Steve Hughes, my partner out at Mason Marin, and on Bright House Inside Motorsports Live. We just finished up our big season out there at Mason Marin. Way to go, big fella.
Kicking off for Centennial, Josh.
Here's a kickoff, and it will be taken and run back a little bit. Taken out there by Hopsey. Hopsey gets up to about the 22-yard line. 7:37 left, 23-point ball game. Centennial just has the pressure of a 31-0 record on them all the time. As the season goes on, that always has to weigh on their minds. They come up against a squad like North High School, who has the number one offense in the area. It takes a lot to get, you know, it takes a lot to get pumped up in some games, and other games it doesn't. Cody Stone hands the ball off to Hoppy. Hoppy, at the end of a long run, takes a hard hit out there by Robin Johnson, but it looks like a first down, or yep, it is.
And they've had a lot of success with that run right there, where they fake that sweep out to one way and they come back underneath. We saw that on that drive when they scored. They were able to make some big plays with this run. And again, it's inside. And I think that's where they've had their best success against this defense is inside.
Well, it's foolish to say the game's over. 7:22 left. North High School has the tools. Stone across the middle. Again, nice catch out there by Anthony Gonzalez. And that's been a nice hookup all night long as well as Gonzalez's interception.
Well, I tell you, man, I mean, I know what you're saying, but Centennial defense is not giving up 23 points in 7 minutes.
It's hard to imagine that Centennial would give up more than three TDs in defense in less than 8 minutes. Hard to imagine. However, there's also magical things that take place when you've got an offense that's used to putting up numbers and used to putting up yards. They've got a rhythm. They've got a chemistry. Here we go. Under 7 minutes. Stone rolls left. Throws across his body. Picked off Ryan Houston. Ryan Houston with a flag on the play after the interception.
There is a penalty flag on the play.
Houston with two picks tonight.
Houston with his second interception of the evening.
And again, he just does a good job when he's sitting in that little zone of reading the quarterback's eyes and making the play on the ball once it goes in the air. It's holding on the return, but, I mean, that's insignificant at this point because he's going to go back and hand the ball to either Chico or you're going to give it to Sparks and you're going to start running some time off this clock.
Well, it looks like Ryan Houston in real time now is holding his side or holding his right hand as we see this replay. And let's see, maybe he takes a shot here at the end, but he looks like he might be holding his right hand or his thumb. But what a nice play by Ryan. And even though it's a penalty flag, you have to wonder if that's not the final nail.
Centennial first down.
Yeah, I just think they don't have no time. I mean, even because they're going to run the ball.
This play will start, and it'll begin the clock at 6:47 left in this ball game. Centennial. Morrell behind center. Chica. Sparks. Sparks gets the call. Sparks gets nowhere. I say that, and he keeps running for 4 yards.
You know, and he's not one of the bigger backs that we've seen, but he just has an ability to never give up when he runs the ball. And if he's able to get past, like, that first tackler, he can carry a few guys.
Another example of a comprehensive and solid program. Josh Bright over here returning to track his punt.
Liberty 9.
Up 23. Did you hear that score? What was it, Matt Whitney? What?
3-9. Liberty
over
9.
Liberty or
Whitney 3, Liberty 9.
Didn't hear it. 6 minutes left to go in this ball game. Centennial marking time right now. Sparks marks it well. Gets another 2 tough yards. That'll bring up about 3rd and 5.
Head up to Charles Sparks, stopped by Chase Chapman.
Brian, with 5:50 left in this ball game, you start thinking of the Golden Hawks and their
remaining schedule there.
Continuous run that they've been having in the league. And next week they've got Golden West at home. That doesn't affect their league. And then they've got West, final game of the season right here. Woo, what a doozy.
And that can be a really big game, you know, depending on how Davidson steps up behind Ybarra as the quarterback for West.
Morrell in the shotgun, 3rd and 4. Tries for the hard camp, can't get it. Perfect play. Quarterback keeper, 11-yard gain, that's a first down, and tried the hard count. Couldn't get everybody to jump, but once they did come across, he had a huge hole.
Yeah, you know, and again, he's had some room to run like that all night long, and as he's had a huge day as a quarterback rushing the ball, from that quarterback position on the direct snaps, and he just takes off. So, you know, Morrell, and he's done a great job directing his offense. He's thrown some touchdown passes, ran for one. I mean, he's just done an excellent job tonight.
North High School, if they don't come back in this one, they'll be 2-1 in league. Next week, West at home, and then at Stockdale. Two tough games. Sparks up the middle. Sparks rounded up at after about a 3-yard gain. Let's talk about the Stars. They've got the Vikings at home and then at Stockdale.
Well, I think the Stars have to win because if they don't, they're putting themselves in a situation where they're going to have to be like Stockdale was last year, when, you know, you're sitting on the bubble for playoffs, you got a decent record, but you finish 3rd or 4th or last or 4th in your division. So I think they're going to definitely have to regroup and figure out a way to win those ball games.
4:15 left in this ball game. 2nd and 6 for the Jayhawks, and you know, right now, as we say, they're marching time, but they've got receivers way split left. Matt Smith, Scott Crosby, the pitch out to Sparks. Sparks trying to make a move. Can he do it? No, but he decides to duck his head and say, hey, Walter Payton's somebody I like, and that's somebody I'll run like. Wow.
Well, what was really smart about it was not only did he put his head down and took it into White, but secondly, he stayed in bounds so the clock continues to roll. And that was a big play right there, because for a second he's going to dip out to the outside and run out of bounds. But he has turned his shoulders up, and you're going to see him right here just lay the plastic down.
Wow.
And the first one on White is on Jason Morris there. So great play there by Sparks.
3.5 left in the ball game. Centennial pulling away in the fourth quarter. 1st and 10, Golden Hawks. Masuda split left. The ball goes to Sparks up the middle. Sparks continues to run hard. Young Charlie Sparks, 5'10", 170, he's a junior. We'll see a lot of him. And as you say, he dropped the helmet and laid into a guy. But we also know he's got great moves. He can run upfield. And we expect to hear a lot of Sparks next 12 months.
Oh, yeah, we will. And I tell you, I like, too, this is what I said. This is why Centennial's hard to stop in the fourth quarter. You want to get the ball back, but you're worn down. That line just keeps coming at you.
Just under 3 minutes left in the ballgame. 2nd and 4. North High School digging in, trying to hold the Golden Hawks, keep them out of the end zone again. Sparks doesn't have anything up middle, tries to cut outside, but just a great play out there by Anthony Goodwin. That North High star is not quitting. No way. None of them are, and he's proven it.
And they're not going to, and that's one of the trademarks they have. I mean, they're a tough, gritty bunch of kids, and every game I've seen, they've always fought to the end, no matter what the score has been.
Coach Mike Snow, fabulous program. Tonight just didn't have things go their way. They did early, and then they started coming back, making a run at things, and then...
Well, they had turnovers, man. They couldn't afford to have turnovers tonight. But also, when Centennial did lose the ball either bounced right back to them or it bounced out of bounds. They just never got those kind of breaks.
Cornelson on the carry. Seems like a different ball carrier whenever I mention something. And when the Golden Hawks have the ball, they just have so many options. Under 2 minutes left, Brian. The young Wooldridge, athlete of the game, there's a few different choices. We hear things in our channels of communication here around things. Some early thoughts.
Well, on defense, you have Ryan Houston. He had two interceptions.
And happy birthday to Shelley Martin.
Caprioli made some big catches.
And
then, you know, you got Morrell. Morrell, like I said, he's pretty much done it all for him tonight. He's run the ball effectively. He's orchestrated the offense. He did have the one interception. Other than that, he really didn't make any mistakes, and he threw a couple touchdown passes. So, I mean, we got three guys that I think are good candidates. I'll be interested to see who we pick as a crew in this game.
Who do you think, Kern County? You're out there watching this ball game. Who is the young Wooldridge athlete of the game in your mind? Well, there's Brian waving, and just as he made a 30-foot putt on the 18th green to take everybody's cash, he's waving around. Hey, tell me about those sticks, my man.
I got to make 30-foot putts because I'm struggling with the 4- and 5-footers.
Oh, my goodness. Brian Adams picks up a new set of sticks, and I don't even think I want to go out there now. 4th and 1. Golden Hawks. Morrell keeps it and holds and pushes through. 1st down, Jayhawks.
Well, Bernie, you need to come out because I'm going to take my lumps here from my partner here if we go out and play, so we should all go out. That way I can come back and say at least I want to beat somebody.
Well, Kern County, Bernie, of course, the director of our football program, just does a knockout job every time. He's got his crew here early on Fridays getting the interviews. Bernard, our director, thinking maybe he's got a little bit of a jump in his step, his golf game, taking on Brian Adams. We'll see.
He said a couple weeks at the range. We just heard that. So now it's on.
Goodness.
Now it's on live or tape delayed, so you'll all hear it. And Vance can't go to the range, but it doesn't matter from what I hear because he's going to shoot like a 71.
Sure I am. Set me up, my man.
70.
Well, here we are, getting even lower than that. 60 seconds left in this ball game. There's Coach Nixon. He's barking out some more orders. 2nd and 7. Enough of this golf nonsense. The Golden Hawks right now putting a cap on another well-played football game, and North High School came at them, gave them a lot, but Centennial withstood it, and the clock continues to tick, and it looks like Brian is going to be 32-0 in league. Very quickly, your comments on that amazing, amazing run.
Well, you know, I think the thing you're talking about is that they're 32-0, but it's over what they're playing, 4 games, 8 years of playing. You know, because there's only in the league, so there's 8 years of basically different players, different coaches, different systems, but football, the same product. Good, hard football. North, they make very few mistakes, and they find a way to win ball games.
Hey, that's it, Kern County. Centennial Golden Hawks knock off the North High Stars, 37-14. We'll be back with our young Wooldridge athlete of the game. Who's it going to be? Golden Hawks win 32-0 in league as they get ready to put the final closing marks on their season here in the next couple weeks. We'll be back in a moment with our young Wooldridge athlete of the game. Who will it be? For Brian Adams, I'm Vance Palms. Please don't miss this. Come back for the special award.
How many pounds?
And the winner is...
With the herbal.
But where is it?
Put it on music choice, man. Go, go, go.
Don't cry for me.
Music Choice, dozens of nonstop music channels on digital cable. Music Choice, where music happens.
The end of this quarter, we'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
Look.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Wooldridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Wooldridge. Integrity you can trust.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work. Listen at home. Listen in the car. The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Welcome back, Kern County Bright House Network football fans. Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams right there. This is Kevin Burton from the law offices of Young Wooldridge, but we have a very special player, Brent Morrell from the Centennial Golden Hawks. Brent, first of all, Brian and I talked about this before the game started. How did Coach Nixon get you mentally prepared to get ready for a team like North High School?
Oh, North High is a great football team, and we just wanted to take every practice so serious and just play day by day and come out all fired up and try to take control from the very beginning, take the belief, whatever they had, out of them, and try to take control of the whole game.
From upstairs, when we watch these games that you Centennial Golden Hawks play, we just notice how many options you have on offense. Tell us what that feels like as a quarterback to know, you know, I've got 3 or 4 or 5 guys I can go to.
Well, first of all, our offensive line is doing an awesome job with our running backs, and it opens up the pass so much because we have a great running game, and all of our wide receivers we have are great, and just looking for any target, it's awesome to have that many good players.
Brian, I know you have a question.
Yeah, my question to you is, taking over as a quarterback from Centennial, one thing you have to do is be accurate and be able to run the ball. A lot of pressure on the quarterback to lead his offense. How have you dealt with the pressure, and do you still feel the pressure in terms of game in, game out, trying to keep that streak alive?
I don't really feel a pressure at all. It's just quarterback's an awesome position here. You have so many things you could do, and with all the how big our line is and how awesome we run the ball, it makes my job so much easier.
Brent, we have a very special presentation. This is the Director of Public Relations and Marketing for the oldest law firm in Kern County, the Law Office of Young Wooldridge. Brent Morrell is our player of the game, Kevin.
Brent, hey, on behalf of the firm, I want to congratulate you on just an awesome job. I think the whole office and defense played tremendous, and fortunately it was against my alma mater, North High. But, hey, you guys played well. I'm going to give you this plaque and a shirt. And, you know, being a junior, I'll probably see you again next year.
Hey, Brent, we know you're going to get back to your teammates here. Let's one final look here at the remainder of your season. You've got Golden West here, and you have West at West. Is that true?
Yes, we do. Golden West was a great game last year. I think we came up a little short over there, but we just want to get some revenge back.
West High School?
That's our last game of the year. It's another strong league game. I think they have one loss this year, and look forward to that game.
That's Brent Morrell, High School Player of the Week for Young Wolverines. Congratulations. Get to it, bud. I know you got to go. Kevin Burton, as we watch this final replay here, Brent Morrell running it in for a big score. Your final thoughts on this big game tonight? I know it's a tough loss for your Stars, but Centennial looks pretty strong this season, don't they, Kevin?
Yeah, they look extremely strong, and I think they've got a pretty good jolt for the first season this year. I mean, they could go all the way.
Kevin Burton, Law Offices, Young Wolverines. Couldn't do the show without you. Appreciate it, bud. Brian? As you're swapping hands here with Kevin, your final thoughts on this big game? Because let's not forget, the score might have, 37-14, but a very big game for both schools.
Well, yes, it was, because for Centennial, they keep their streak alive, and they're going to be able to have a good chance to go out now and complete the sweep of the league and win, and also get home field advantage in the playoffs, which I think is a very key position.
Brian, great job as always. Thank you, Kevin. Appreciate you being here. That's Kevin Burton. That's Brian Adams. I'm Vance Palm. Next week, Ridgeview at Foothill. Ow! For Halloween, it ought to be a real fun game. Thanks for being here. We'll see you next week. Ridgeview at Foothill. For everybody involved in our production team, thanks for being with us. Good night. God bless.